Hey everyone, can you feel it? Is there a change in the air? That's right, spring is almost here. Spring is a time for new beginnings, fresh starts, and of course, learning new vocabulary. In this video, we're going to be diving headfirst into the world of spring vocabulary in English. We'll learn all about the sights, sounds, and experiences that make this season so special. So, grab your notebooks and get ready to bloom with knowledge. Let's start with some spring vocabulary that can be tricky. Bloom and blossom. We use these words when we talk about flowers, and both words have a noun form and a verb form. The noun form bloom is actually a synonym of flower. It's most often used in the expression in full bloom, which means with the flowers fully open. The roses were in full bloom. The verb form of bloom means to produce flowers. Most roses will begin to bloom at the end of May. The noun form of blossom means a flower or a mass of flowers, especially on a fruit tree or bush. The cherry blossoms are beautiful this year. The verb form of blossom means to produce blossom. The cherry trees blossomed early this year. Confused? Look at the two sentences together. The cherry blossoms are beautiful this year. The noun cherry blossoms are the subject of the sentence. Are is the verb. The noun form is usually plural, blossoms. The cherry trees blossomed early this year. The noun cherry trees are the subject of the sentence. Blossomed is the verb. The verb is in the past tense. Spring is a season of renewal. Plants and animals become active again as the weather gets warmer. It's a happy time of year. Unless you have allergies. An allergy is a medical condition that causes you to react badly or feel sick when you eat or touch something. Trees and flowers are beautiful, but they also create a lot of pollen in spring. Pollen is a fine powder made by flowers and carried by the wind. An allergy caused by pollen is called hay fever in English. People who suffer from hay fever sneeze a lot and have itchy, watery eyes during spring. Sneeze, verb, to have air come suddenly and noisily out through your nose and mouth in a way that you cannot control. Itchy means you have an uncomfortable feeling on your skin that makes you want to scratch it. Watery, adjective, of or like water, containing a lot of water. His eyes were red and watery. When we say someone's eyes are watery, it means they have water in their eyes, usually from air conditions or allergies. This is different from crying. Birds come back in spring, or they become active in spring. We can hear their singing and chirping more often than in the winter months. The noun form of chirp is a short, high sound made by small birds and some insects. The verb form of chirp is to make short, high sounds. I can hear birds chirping in the tree. Here's a recap of the 11 new words we learned in today's video. I hope they're helpful for you the next time you want to talk to your friends in English about spring where you live. Thanks for watching and have a great day.